Hello, my name is MaryD, and welcome to my YouTube channel, MaryD Plays. In this video, we're doing the Fender Play app, the random exercise and riff that is sent to my phone each day, Monday through Friday. Today's random exercise and riff is drill the E major pentatonic scale, and the riff is I Love Music by the OJs, which apparently I've already done before. So there you have it. Let's begin. Information. Drill the E major pentatonic. By the end of this lesson, you will learn you understand how to identify the E major pentatonic scale. It's a five-note scale. Practice playing the pentatonic scale in the key of E. So, and here's the tabs. All right, let's listen.
In this exercise, we're going to practice playing the E major pentatonic scale, ascending and descending, across all four strings. This time, we'll be playing each note of the scale only once. For this exercise, we're playing a full two-octave scale as quarter notes. Here it is, ascending and descending. Here we go. And descending. Awesome. Let's take a look at our fret hand first. Remember to shift on the fourth finger on the way up the scale, and to shift with your first finger on the way down the scale. Shifts only occur on your D string and G string. Let's take a look at that. We start with our E major pentatonic scale. Here's one octave, and here's our first shift with your fourth finger. And here's our second shift with our fourth finger. Now when we descend, we play fourth finger, first finger, then shift with your first finger. And shift again with your first finger. Awesome. Now let's take a look at our rhythm hand. We'll be playing steady quarter notes with an alternating pattern of your index and middle finger. If you feel comfortable, when you're descending the scale, use a rake technique. That would look like this. Great. Here's what the whole exercise sounds like. Descending. Awesome. Let's try it together. We'll be playing steady quarter notes at 75 beats per minute. We'll play each note of the scale only once. Let's play the whole thing five times together. Here we go. One, two, ready, play. And descending. There's one. And descending. There's two. And descending. There's three. And descend. There's four. And descend. And there's five. Great job. When you've got this one down, try to increase the tempo and focus on keeping your shifts super clean in both directions. Keep practicing and see you next time.
Okay, going to play again, and then I'm switching over to full screen tabs.
In this exercise, we're going to practice playing the E major pentatonic scale, ascending and descending, across all four strings. This time, we'll be playing each note of the scale only once. For this exercise, we're playing a full two-octave scale as quarter notes. Here it is, ascending and descending. Here we go. And descending. Awesome. Let's take a look at our fret hand first. Remember to shift on the fourth finger on the way up the scale, and to shift with your first finger on the way down the scale. Shifts only occur on your D string and G string. Let's take a look at that. We start with our E major pentatonic scale. Here's one octave, and here's our first shift with your fourth finger. And here's our second shift with our fourth finger. Now when we descend, we play fourth finger, first finger, then shift with your first finger. And shift again with your first finger. Awesome. Now let's take a look at our rhythm hand. We'll be playing steady quarter notes with an alternating pattern of your index and middle finger. If you feel comfortable, when you're descending the scale, use a rake technique. That would look like this. Great. Here's what the whole exercise sounds like. Let's try it together. We'll be playing steady quarter notes at 75 beats per minute. We'll play each note of the scale only once. Let's play the whole thing five times together. Here we go. One, two, ready, play. And descending. Focus on keeping your shifts super clean in both directions. Keep practicing and see you next time.
I made a couple mistakes. All right, I'm going to go through and do this on my own a few times. Okay, get ready to explore basic alternate plucking and strain muting with this laid-back R&B hit. In this lesson, you'll learn finger placement, alternate plucking, and strain muting. And here's the tabs.
Here's the simplified riff for I Love Music by the OJs. It's just two notes and can be played throughout most of the song. It sounds like this. With the fret hand, we have our first finger on the first fret of the E string for an F, and then our fourth finger on the third fret of the E string for a G. So we've got F and G. And we play that F, F, G, G, F, F, G. Let's take a look at that from another angle. We have our first finger on the first fret for F, and our fourth finger on the third fret of the E for G. Now with the rhythm hand here, we have quarter note rhythms here, all quarter notes. And we're alternating our index and middle finger. You're going to rest on the last beat of bar two. So do your best to stop the string from ringing out using your fret hand or your rhythm hand so you're stopping that sound. So putting it all together, we have F, F, G, G, F, F, G, rest. F, F, G, G, F, F, G, rest. Let's take a closer look at the rhythm hand. We have alternating, index, and middle finger here. And then rest by stopping the sound of the string. Now let's put the riff section together. We're going to play the section four times through. So get ready with your F note and I'll count you in. One, two, three, four. And rest. Steady quarter notes here, alternating index and middle finger. And then rest. This is number three. And the last time.
Okay, gonna watch that again.
Here's the simplified riff for I Love Music by the OJs. It's just two notes and can be played throughout most of the song. It sounds like this. With the fret hand, we have our first finger on the first fret of the E string for an F, and then our fourth finger on the third third fret of the E string for a G. So we've got F and G. And we play that F, F, G, G, F, F, G. Let's take a look at that from another angle. We have our first finger on the first fret for F, and our fourth finger on the third fret of the E for G. Now with the rhythm hand here, we have quarter note rhythms here, all quarter notes. And we're alternating our index and middle finger. You're going to rest on the last beat of bar two. So do your best to stop the string from ringing out using your fret hand or your rhythm hand so you're stopping that sound. So putting it all together, we have F, F, G, G, F, F, G, rest. F, F, G, G, F, F, G, rest. Let's take a closer look at the rhythm hand. We have alternating index and middle finger here, and then rest by stopping the sound of the string. Now let's put the riff section together. We're going to play the section four times through. So get ready with your F note and I'll count you in. One, two, three, four. And rest.